The second seed from Spain, Rafael Nadal.
One of the most popular figures in world sport, bidding for his 11th Grand Slam championship.
Novak Djokovic.
The Serbian walks out onto a court that he would like to call his own.
Footwork. That's what he wants to do.
You call it, Jeffrey.
He looked the man more likely, and so it proves. Rafael Nadal takes the first step in the final in 2012 after 1 hour and 20 minutes.
Right on the paint.
That's super stuff from both players.
Oh.
he's found his stride here. That's a beautifully constructed point.
On the line.
Yeah. And this time, he doesn't let an opportunity slip by. Who won 10 titles last year.
Anticipation.
Double faults have decided a couple of big points. Djokovic levels up the match. He was the favourite before it started. He's probably a slight favourite again. We're a set apiece in the final after 2 hours and 27 minutes.
Set up by another outstanding return of serve. Wow, that's fantastic. Absolutely awesome.
Of power swings. Yeah. He is well and truly in control.
That's the shot that gets him again.
Oh. Yeah. It's It's hard to see where the turnaround is going to come from. Novak Djokovic looking supremely confident. Djokovic up the break, 5-2 in the third. That's the way it's looking at the moment. The roar goes up from Djokovic and his supporters, and seemingly he's on his way. 2-1 after 3 hours and 11 minutes. He has to.
Until it bounced.
But how about the return, Fred? He was on the baseline and went after it. Haven't seen that since the first set.
Somehow he finds a way.
Too good.
Novak Djokovic has had that look about him since the third set, and now finds himself in a position of standing on the verge of dominance. What he does.
Oh, come on.
Tough after the rain delay. Not on your life. Try a love game. Try one for the highlights reel as well.
Oh, that is brilliant. That is brilliant.
Fasten your seatbelts. Here we go.
6-4.
Man, and why not?
Playing the best tennis of the match so far, Nadal.
Nadal collapses to his knees and then bounces straight back up because he knows the job is still there to be done. It'll probably be the longest match in Australian Open history by the time it's over. This is magnificent. It is two sets apiece.
Oh, well, how can he hit that from there? He's absolutely running backwards, thinking the ball is going to go out.
Might that be the straw that breaks the camel's back? Starting to hit the lines.
Can you believe it?
Back to back breaks of serve, and this epic contest, which is now the longest match in Australian Open history, is going to be going for a fair bit longer.
Much better. Finally move forward on one.
That's unbelievable. Djokovic is down.
Normally, players only collapse to the court when they win the championship. His body, well, you wouldn't blame it for failing him. 31 points in the rally, and the crowd just standing and applauding. They're standing up here.
Yes. Yeah, even Uncle Tony applauding that.
He's got new balls to help him try to do it.
Oh.
sit back and applaud the efforts of these two men.
Got to get in.
Towards the chair, knowing that in a moment he'll be serving for the championship in 2012. Is overused. Not this time. When they write the story of the great tennis matches ever played, this one has got to be right up the front of the book. 5 hours and 53 minutes. Novak Djokovic is the champion in Melbourne for the third time. That was simply extraordinary. Novak Djokovic. It's 20-2 on a Monday morning in Melbourne. Hardly anyone has left. Hardly anyone was able to leave. Just at this moment, as the champion celebrates, spare a thought for the vanquished tonight. As brave a performance as Rafael Nadal has probably ever produced in his life, and yet he still walks away empty-handed. Djokovic wins it 7-5 in the fifth set in 5 hours and 53 minutes. Have we ever seen the likes of it? The 100th Australian Open final is probably the best.